Hello, Shady.
Right, where are you, dears?
We're in the library in the Fab Lab.
Uh-huh. Is that the place where I go to? Because I'm the Fab.
Move over a bit so you can hear.
JD,
it is. It's open. I know you found it shut the other day, but I think it's open more often now.
Yeah.
And we're here with Simon.
Yes.
We're going to move the phone over towards him so he can explain more about the Fab Lab.
Oh, great. That's what I'd like to know, because I have been there yesterday and I didn't know what they did in there.
Hello.
Hello. Hi.
Hi. We are trying to be more open, have longer opening hours now.
That's good.
We're open Tuesday, Wednesday and Thursday. Monday and Friday are still a little bit difficult at the moment. On Saturdays, we have workshops in here, and we're open some Sundays as well now.
Oh, great. That's good, because I went there yesterday, and it was closed, of course, and I just wondered what you do there.
We've got lots of digital making equipment. We've got 3D printers,
mm-hmm.
We've got a laser cutter, we've got a router, we've got some sewing machines, embroidery machines, t-shirt making machines, soldering irons, raspberry pies. We've got all sorts of stuff. But the thing that's probably caught the most attention, obviously, are the 3D printers, because people are very interested in those at the moment.
Yes, that is the newest technology, isn't it?
That's right, yeah. And we've actually got 5 of those in here.
5, wow. So what does the 3D printer do then? Because a lot of people don't know exactly what it does.
No, you have to design something, first of all, to put in it. But mm-hmm. it'll print out an object, so a three-dimensional object. Pretty much anything that you can think of or design or draw, excuse me, it'll be able to print out. And it does it by a process of just sort of building up layer upon layer of a plastic filament that it melts as it goes across.
Oh, right. So it's like, you know, if you take a picture of a building, you can see right round the back of it.
That's right.
And over the top. Wow, that's quite a new technology, isn't it, really, in the long run?
Yeah, it's a very new technology. And obviously, the ones we've got here are sort of at the low end of the scale.
Right.
They're very expensive. They are using them in, I was reading the other day that Formula One use them a lot these days.
Wow.
On their cars. So they don't have to manufacture a bit. They can actually build a bit while they're at the circuit.
Wow, that's amazing, isn't it? So it actually takes the sort of the technology of today and puts it into biggest perspective, so that we can plan new buildings, new things like that with this technology.
That's right, absolutely. And here, obviously, we've only got sort of very small ones.
Yes, so it gives you a flavour of it, doesn't it?
That's right. It gives you a good introduction to it. And we start off, when we do workshops, just sort of introductory workshops for people, we start off by just getting them to design a keyring with their name on it.
Uh-huh.
Then right. Print it out. So it's a very simple sort of start, but it gives you a really sort of clear idea of what they can do. And then you can take it from there, really, hopefully. Come back to us with a bigger project that we can build.
Right. So that's what the Fab Lab is to build bigger projects, is it?
Well, the idea really is that people can come in and build maybe prototypes if they've got a sort of design idea or a business idea even that they want to develop. We can certainly help them in building a prototype that they can then take somewhere else and just see if that's going to, you know, be able to put out to market and that sort of thing.
Oh, good. It's like a stepping stone for those inventors, shall we say.
Exactly. And we're also interested in working with artists and other creative people.
Uh-huh.
If a sculptor, for example, wants to make something from a 3D printer instead of carving it out of wood or stone,
right.
We're interested in working in those sort of projects as well.
Because, yes, that's right. Taking it back to that car thing, is that they have to make the models in the olden days with, you know, plasterboard or whatever. And now you can just do it with a photograph, couldn't you?
That's right. You can. We've actually just got a little handheld scanner as well.
3D. Oh, wow, that's good.
You can, although we're sort of still getting to grips with the software and technology of it. But eventually that should be up and running quite successfully. So you will be able to just sort of scan something and then be able to print that out.
So, we as I said, this program goes out to people with disabilities. So, how can that be helping their sort of life, do you think?
Well, I think there's probably there's many ways that they could use the lab. I mean, the lab is it's accessible to start with, so it's quite easy to get in and out of.
Good.
The library is a very accessible building.
Good.
There's good access for everyone. I mean, if someone was thinking of maybe some sort of object or something that might help them, thinking, you know, just off the top of my head, say someone in a wheelchair who wanted some sort of device that could help them reach things or make their life easier in that way, that they could design something, we could actually build that then for them.
Oh, wow, that's really moving. It's putting technology in the right sense. You know, we've got some rubbishy things on the market at the moment, and you know, put the technology into good use. I think
that's right. Yeah, absolutely, and that's what we're all about here. And, you know, we're the library itself. You know, we carry on from their sort of ethos that we're open and accessible to everyone, and you know, anyone can come in and use our equipment and. Our services.
Does this go? Could we apply this to like mapping? Because at the moment you've got Google, and Google does its sort of map thing, but that's done on an image which they've taken the image from. Could that be incorporated in that?
To be honest, I'm not really sure.
I was just thinking ideas, you see, to help people with disability with getting around. You know, whether it's you know, a 3D something in their hand,
yes,
you know, which they've made for themselves to identify where they are if they're blind, to even those which just need a little bit of help to get into a building.
Right. Yes.
Sorry, put you on the spot, haven't I?
I'm a bit. It would require some thought. And,
yeah. It's those ideas, isn't it? When you know, you've got great ideas and you can actually develop them yourself as you've got the Fab Lab there, to actually come and do it, you know, free or, you know, with a cost, I suppose. But you've got you've got the equipment there to do it with.
That's right. And there's a lot of, because we're working, the sort of model that we're working on is that there's a membership fee.
Right.
Membership fee, and then you'd be able to come in and use the equipment. There would be a charge, sort of hourly rate,
right,
but materials if you're doing the 3D printer. That's the sort of model that we're working towards, although it's not up and running quite yet.
Right.
But the advantage of having that sort of system is that we have a lot of volunteers with a lot of specialist knowledge. So there might be someone who's an absolute expert in on the router, for example, but knows nothing else about the sewing machine.
Well, that's good, because you could be quite daunting to go into a room with all those machines and don't know how to use them.
Well, that's right. But what it means is that if someone comes through the door and has an idea, point them to someone who can say, yeah, that'll work. Or if they're stuck at some point, we can again point them towards someone who might be able to just give them that bit of help or an extra bit of knowledge that will allow them to then move that forward.
Yes, good.
In layman's terms, what a router, please. I visualise it being a router that puts your internet signal.
Right. Okay. Yes, this is slightly different. A router. Yeah. It is just basically like a big drill. So it's a drill head with a drill bit in it, and then it's always sort of pointing downwards and will cut out an object. So it'll sort of just, by gentle little strokes, go round and round whatever you've programmed it to do to make a shape. So it's sort of carved in a way. If you put a block of wood in it, you can get it to sort of carve something out of that.
So you do that and all the things around it, we can see you do lots of technological things. So do you have any events on a regular basis, such as, well, we saw a poster on the way in about the Raspberry Pi event.
Yes, we do. We have the Fab Lab at the moment. We're running workshops every Saturday morning. The one's coming up this Saturday is on the laser cutter. We did one last week on the router. These are free workshops. They are limited in numbers, obviously, because the room is relatively small. And if you're working on the laser cutter, for example, you can't have more than four or five people around it. Otherwise, you can't see what's going on.
Yeah.
But any events and workshops that we're running in the Fab Lab are all, you can view those that are coming up on the website, which is fablabdevon.org. And if you click on the menu bit where it says workshops, that'll show you what's coming up. And you can book your tickets on there. And as I say, they're all free events. And the library itself is running the Raspberry Pi event. We have a Raspberry Jam here every month on the first Saturday of every month, where people come in and, again, help people to get started on their own Raspberry Pis or show off what they've been doing and explain how they're using their Raspberry Pi to control the robot or whatever it is that they've bought it.
Well, thank you for your time, Peter.
You're welcome.
What we've seen today looks very interesting.
Good.
And thank you for giving us feedback.
You're welcome. Nice to meet
you. Okay. So is that all you have to ask, JD?
Yeah, that's fantastic. I shall go over there and do some fab labbing.
Yes. Hopefully we'll be open when you next come in.
Yes, next time I come over, that's great.
JD, you can't build a car, though.
Oh, I want a supersonic car, which doesn't have any wheels, and get me here in 2 seconds.
Okay, well, you're going to have a debate with Simon whether that's achievable.
Yeah, we'll have a debate over that coffee later on, shall we?
Yes, let's do that.
Okay, well, we'll be back soon, JD.
Okay, so, thank you. Lovely. Thanks a lot, everybody. That's fantastic.
Thank you for your time, Simon, and we will see you soon, JD.
Okay, thank you. That's people over at the Fab Lab for us. Fantastic place. And that's at the library. Exeter Library. They have fab coffee as well.